Hello Hungry fam, my name is Akansha and welcome to our channel. Today I'm going to test few gadget hacks from 5 minute crafts and check if they are real or fake. Before starting the video, like, share and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all the post notifications. For the first gadget, I have a corn stripper or corn cutter gadget. You have to place the corn cutter attachment over the measuring cup which is provided in the box. Now I'm going to rotate the whole corn over the stripper. Apply a bit of pressure and keep rotating the corn. When you reach midway, remove it out. Turn it upside down. Add the corn holder so that you have a good grip. And keep twisting. Wow, the kernels are getting separated very easily. But when you flip, the stem part gets stuck, as you can see. But don't worry, remove the cutter from the measuring cup and then keep rotating. It becomes thoda sa messy, but it's so easy and efficient to use. Love this gadget so far. I'm also going to try it with boiled corn. I boiled the whole corn cob in the pressure cooker and peeling the boiled kernels is even easier. This gadget has one more attachment, so I'm going to grate cheese over it. The grater part looks a bit clumsy, but it's very sharp and mess-free. You can also measure how much ingredient you have grated, which is amazing. Highly recommend you all to try this gadget. For me, it was definitely a 9.5 on 10. This gadget looks so good. I'm super excited to test it out. I'm going to use this chocolate cake batter. I will upload its recipe as a YouTube Shorts on Monday at 1 p.m. I'm filling the batter till 3/4. Now bake it at 180 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. Look at how beautifully it's rising. This cake is my recent favorite recipe. Comes out so perfect every time I bake it. After removing it from the oven, let it cool down for 5 minutes. Then flip it over. To demold it, just tap on the bottom a bit. It comes out very easily. You can literally see the texture even without cutting it open. I'm going to sprinkle some icing sugar over it. You can decorate it with whipped cream or any icing you like. It's very decadent and not too sweet, but just perfect. It's very convenient since you get individual pastry slices and it's super easy to clean just like a normal cupcake mold. Love the result of this cake pastry making gadget. So for me, this gadget was a big success. Next gadget, we have a silicone kneading dough bag. I'm adding 1 glass of flour into it and 1/2 cup of water. Tie the open side with the string lock they have provided. Now start kneading how you usually do. Takes a bit more time and you don't really understand the measurements of the dough. Like you don't know if the dough is very soft or it's hard because the silicone is very thick, so it's not completely see-through. It's been 15 minutes I'm kneading it. Now let's check how the dough has turned out. Okay, the dough is actually really good than I expected. It doesn't have a very smooth finishing, but it's okay. You can add a bit of oil and knead it again to smoothen it out. It's definitely mess-free and very easy to use and clean. So for me, this gadget was an 8 on 10. Also, I've mentioned all the gadget links in the description box below. You can definitely check them out. The next gadget I ordered was actually a vegetable ribbon cutter, but received a wafer machine instead. When I tried to order it again, it's not available now. And the return date for this product has also passed long back. So let's test this one out only. I'm placing a cucumber in the center and then just rotate the wheel. Okay, that works beautifully and it's so much fun to rotate the wheel. You get very thin slices. It's perfect if you want to make chips or any salad. Couldn't test the 5 minute craft, but this wafer machine is a 10 on 10. For the next fries cutter gadget, I place the potato on the crisscross blades and I'm trying to push it down using the top part of the gadget. After applying a lot of pressure, I can't even move the potato a bit. I feel the plastic will break easily because it's so clumsy. But Advait is going to give it a try. You also saw how much pressure he applied. You get a nice cut, but it gets stuck from the end and you have to pull the fries out. I'm going to try it again, but it's literally the same. The pressure it requires is way too much. I feel knife say it's so much easier to cut fries. So for me, this gadget was busted and I'm going to rate it a 2 on 10. For the next gadget, I'm going to flatten out a pastry dough into a rectangular shape. Roll it as thin as possible. Then I'm going to just roll this pastry cutter over the thinly flattened dough. Okay, it's getting completely stuck even after adding so much of dry flour on the tabletop. So for the second try, I'm using a plain maida dough. Okay, so the dough is getting stuck in between the blades. This time I rolled it out even more thinly. But somehow I managed to cut it through. As you can see, it's not getting the exact design on the back side. After many trials, I could manage to give design on half of the flattened dough. You need to apply a lot of pressure to get the cut or else it doesn't work on the other side. Looks very pretty though. Actually, I'm very tired to bake a pie now. So let me know if you want a separate video on pie recipes. I would love to make them. But to test it, I'm just going to bake the crust for 8 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. The design held its shape, which is amazing, but it takes a lot of time to get this design. So for me, this gadget is a 50-50. For the next gadget, which looks amazing, I'm washing few potatoes. And then to drain out the water, I'm just lifting this gadget. Wow, what a fail that was. I guess I didn't attach it properly. So I'm going to fix it and try it again. Okay, you can see how easily the water is draining out. This is definitely going to be very handy. You can also strain noodles, pasta, or any vegetables you want. This gadget quality is really good and it's very sturdy as well. So I'm going to rate it a 9 on 10. For the next gadget, I'm going to make ramen noodles. A lot of you also requested its recipe. In a hot pan, add oil. Then add 1 teaspoon of garlic, saute for a minute, then add 1/2 cup broccoli, then add 1/2 teaspoon of salt and black pepper powder, mix it and let it cook for 5 minutes. Remove it into a bowl. Then I'm using the Shin Ramen noodles, going to follow the exact recipe mentioned on the packet. Add 550 ml of water and let it boil. Then add the soup sachet and the veg mix. See, so this is literally my go-to ramen noodles. Then I'm adding the noodles and let it cook for 5 minutes. Now I'm going to attach the side funnel on the rim of the pan. Add noodles in the bowl along with the broccoli. I'm going to try and pour the soup into the bowl. But as you can see, it is falling out from, I guess, the funnel gap, which is to attach it to the rim. I don't want to waste any more food, so won't be trying it again. But the quality of this funnel is honestly horrible. It's very clumsy and definitely busted. I'm rating it a 0 on 10, but the ramen is amazing. Definitely try out this recipe. Try these fun gadgets and let me know your feedback. Today's shout out goes to Mimansa Mishra, Ishan Patil who is Shravani and Urvashi Tiwari who is Diksha. If you want a shout out, all you have to do is subscribe to our channel, follow us on Instagram and comment on this video telling me that you have. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more amazing videos.